Good afternoon. It is Monday, April 23rd, 2007. This is Brian Shannon speaking from Alpha Trends, and the market's closed. I've got the S&P 500 on the screen right now. The Spiders did lose 49 cents today, or 0.32%. And as extended as this market is, we do have to be careful and expect at least a pullback, if not something more serious. But there's no sign of anything more serious here on any time frame we look at. We can see that the market is clearly in a very good uptrend. Looking at this 10-minute time frame, you can see again that this five-day moving average is still advancing. And as long as it does so, as a short-term traders, we want to give the benefit of the doubt to the buyers in this market. The best support really is probably down at that 147.50 level. That's the prior high that looked like it was starting to act as support on Friday, and that's also the location of the five-day moving average. Below that, I think you could go straight down $1 to about 146.50. So that's our more important levels of support. The market is getting extended, but there's no reason to sell the market just because low volume was present, or just because a MACD is overbought, or whatever reason you're looking for. Clearly, the shorts have been getting buried in this market, and it shows why I think the best way to make money in the market is to trend trade. And taking a look at the NASDAQ 100, the Qs here on the screen, we still don't have a breakout yet in this market officially. You know, who cares if it's officially, I guess. But realistically, 45 and a half or so, getting above that level is what I would consider a breakout. And that's, again, that's just words. It doesn't really mean anything because the market's in an uptrend. And that's what's most important here. Price is what pays us. And these Qs were up actually 7 cents today, 0.15%. Looking at a 10-minute time frame, again, same thing here. This five-day moving average acted as support last Thursday, and that five-day moving average continues to advance. It's also in the location of this prior level of resistance at 45.20. So I think 45.20, 45.10, that's probably the best level of support for the Qs right now. We've got a little bit of resistance at about 45.60, so maybe that's what it takes for an official breakout. But again, that's just something that someone can write about in the newspaper. What we're going to look at is price action and focus on that. As long as it remains higher, then official breakout in the market really doesn't matter. What we're looking for is trading ideas. And the semiconductors have been the big area of strength last week. And like I said, that was the more important news event as far as market action goes last week. We had the breakout past $36 a share, $35.90 maybe. And it did attain our target from this inverted head and shoulders pattern that I had outlined for the last 2 weeks or so. Breaking past there, we were looking for a move up to $36.30. We got that target attained. Now, what I was hoping for, and it looks like we're starting to see, is a low volume pullback. You see the volume is drying up a little bit here relative to the advancing volume. So hopefully this market can continue to pull back and maybe meet up with its rising 10-day moving average at 35.70, 35.80, somewhere in there. We're not going to try and guess where the market will pull back to. I'm sure a lot of people are looking at the market like this saying, well, 35.50 is a one-third retracement. That's where I'm going to buy. I think that's the wrong way to do it. It's a potential area of support, and it's where we had a little bit of support right here on this day as well. But let's see what happens. Let's see if the market, in fact, does pull back price-wise. It might be just consolidating through time in here. Maybe we'll get a little bit of a shakeout below here, trap some shorts in, and then break back out. I think right now I would be more bullish on this market above about 36.20, and I would consider possibility of a long, but I'd rather see a day or two more of consolidative action for these semiconductors. But they clearly are a very bullish looking group when you look at that daily time frame, and when you look at this weekly time frame. Again, I'm going to point out the 10, 20, and 40 week moving averages, or the 50, 100, and 200 week moving averages, are all advancing. We've got the 10 above the 20, above the 40. That tells me the trends are higher, and these longer term trends on the weekly time frame are the trends that are controlled by large institutions that have, you know, hundreds of millions of dollars. So they're clearly committed, it looks like, at this point. Let's see if they remain committed or if this market fails. Right now there is zero sign that it is failing. What we want to do is look for a better entry point right now. The IWM, the Russell 2000, this market hasn't quite broken out either, but when you're up at all-time highs, it's really not that important. What we need to focus on instead is the prior level of resistance holding a support. And here, that level that we were focusing on was $81 a share. That did hold a support. Now it looks like it's consolidating underneath this level. And it looks poised for a breakout above 82.50. Maybe we could get some further gains in here. But currently, the market action continues to remain very bullish. There's no sign of trouble in the overall indices. Of course, there's always going to be individual stocks that are troublesome, and we are in earnings season, so that's, again, something to be aware of. But let's take a look at the stocks that I've mentioned over the weekend. First of all, this Exelixis, or whatever it's called, EXEL is the symbol. I wanted to see the stock pull back to $10.90, which it did do right in here, and then to buy it on strength above 11.05, which it didn't do right here. So it should have been involved at about 11.05 at this point. Our stop was then going to be $10.82, and I think we want to leave our stop at 10.82 for now until the stock can rally a little bit further, and hopefully we can begin to start thinking about locking in some gains. $6.10 was the level that I had suggested buying HOKU if it got above that level. The stock did not trade above $6.10. There was really no reason to get involved in that one from the long side today. Polycom, I had suggested a short sale below $33.20. You see that occurred right in here. Our stop was going to be at $33.55. And I think that you can now raise that, we're a shorts position, so lower that stop down to $32.26. So we're essentially taking all the risk out of it. As we did in Solarfun, SOLF, this one I had suggested buying above $16.20, and it got above that right in here early on. And once it rallied up to $16.50, I said at that point, rather than keeping our stop way down at $15.70 a share, way down here, what I wanted to do at that point was to raise our stop to break even. So you should have been stopped out at break even right here. There was no reason to keep that original stop and then take a loss, because this, the stock did fail. So there's no reason to be involved. Officially, we're stopped out at break even. SuperGen, SUPG, I had suggested buying this one above $6.90. You can see that occurred right in here. It was acting good for a little bit, but unfortunately, it did come down and hit our stop of $6.74. So we were stopped out with just a 15-cent loss in there. So very, very small loss because we had a tight stop in there.